Hello and welcome to Polymer Update. I am Pratiksha Karkera and joining me today is industry veteran Mr. Vijay Merchant. He has thrice been elected as the president of the All India Plastics Manufacturers Association. He is also the founder member of the Indian Center for Plastics in the Environment. He is also the owner and director of Polycraft, an exporter of industrial plastic products. Mr. Merchant, thank you for joining us on Polymer Update.
My pleasure.
And today we're going to talk on, is our world heading towards a plastics planet? So sir, plastics are perceived negatively by many. Don't you think the awareness of plastics as a necessity is somewhere lacking?
It is true. The thing is that plastics have gained so much in the last 30-40 years, so many new applications, that people have gone ahead and made the products and supplied to the market without realizing there's a need to pass on this information about the material to the consumers and what it can do for you and how you should take care of it once it's used.
With 7 billion tons of plastics still left untouched for recycling, we have made an island of trash. Is responsible recycling of plastics a solution to this very grave problem?
At the first, I would say, I'm not quite sure of the figure of 7 billion. Nevertheless, of course, as the consumption increases and because of necessity of the market, there will be waste. The same waste is there, it has to be properly segregated, it has to be recycled and put to use again. This is obvious. If a material is so versatile that it doesn't disintegrate or doesn't fall apart like the natural products, it has to be reused at some reason or some time or the other. And for that, you have to have a segregation system in place. You've got to have some facilities whereby people can pick it up or pick up all the waste and send it for recycling.
Plastics are omnipresent. Let's accept it. We can find plastics everywhere. Sadly, even in our oceans, where 8 million metric tons of plastic had entered in 2010, numerous cases of sea animals swallowing plastic items were reported. So, what do you think should be done to maintain a balance in the environment and resolve this problem?
The thing is, now we have done a lot of studies on this worldwide, and we are part of an action group where we find out that almost 80% of the plastics getting into the waterways of the oceans is from the land. It is not directly from the oceans. Only 20% is there from the sea, in the sense that maybe ships throwing their waste across, or for that matter fishermen leaving their fishing nets or their gear, etc., in the sea, which remains there. Otherwise, 80% goes from the land. The thing is, you need to take care of the material doesn't get from the land to the waterways or the sea. And for this, you require a change in mindset.
Absolutely. So with plastics awareness being the major concern, the manufacturing part of plastics is somewhere targeted as the main cause for littering, and it eventually creates plastics waste. So people have a disregard towards plastics. How can this notion be rectified?
You've got to look at it holistically. You cannot say plastic manufacturers are causing litter. It's human beings like you and me that cause a litter, and it is not that the plastic manufacturers want this to be littered. Plastic manufacturers are making products or making packages or making systems or offering items to the buyers. It may be a multinational, it may be a consumer goods company, it may be a supermarket, and it may be a pharmaceutical company. All these people, besides the farmers, etc., all use plastics for some sort of packaging or the other. The thing is, after it is used, how do you deal with it? And for this, I feel it is not the manufacturer alone. Of course, manufacturers do have a responsibility, but the responsibility has to be shared by all the stakeholders.
Absolutely, sir. So, sir, talking about blanket bans, because a blanket ban on plastic bags of 50 micron has been implemented across many Indian states. So, what do you think should be done? What is it true that all the Indian states have implemented this ban? And was it a right decision to ban an item which barely has any alternatives?
I don't think it was a recommendation. The Union Ministry of Environment and Forest had brought out a notification after a lot of deliberations. Earlier it was 30 microns, then it became 50 microns, because they felt that the thin bags were not being picked up, and as a result of which causing litter nuisance, as a result of which it was a hazard for the environment. The thing is that all these states have not even notified it. Most of the states may have notified it, but the question of notification, it doesn't stop at the notification stage. It has to be properly implemented, and for that the state has to play a role. the citizens have to play a role, and everybody has to take care of it, that this 50 micron rule is enforced and followed by everybody, after which of course you have to leave it to the recyclers to pick up the material and put it to another use. Why I say this is that there are countries in the world which even today are using 8 micron bags. There are countries in the world which are using 12 micron bags. There are countries in the world using 20 micron bags. And they don't seem to be having the problem that we have. Because the thing is that people have been accustomed to anti-litter or been educated at the earlier stages that litter is a nuisance. And if you once you are able to pass this message on to the population in India, I'm sure things would improve.
So plastics are used for manufacturing innumerable products, right from household commodities to process manufacturing. But what about its waste that are hazardous to the society?
Plastic is an inert material. People dubbing it as a hazardous material, hazardous waste, is once again a misconception. Plastics, if it is by itself, nothing will happen to it. You have plastic implants in the body. Now, if it was a hazardous material, do you think any doctor or any physician or any person would ever recommend that use it? You use plastic syringes for injecting patients with all sorts of problems, all sorts of disease, all sorts of ailments. Now, that is because plastic by itself is inert. The thing is that when it lies around, when it attracts dirt, when it attracts oil or whatever waste is there, it sticks onto it, it becomes a nuisance. So by itself, it's not a hazard. But the thing is that if you leave it alone and lie there, it does cause a problem for society.
So sir, does this curb the usage of plastics in daily life as such?
I doubt very much, because the reason why plastics has come in the market or has come into use all over the world is because it happens to be one of the most economical products possible, material possible, at the same time very environmentally friendly, because the CO2 or what you call the carbon imprint of plastics versus say metals or for that matter glass, etc., is comparable, and you can say it's far better to have a application of plastics in so many places rather than use the traditional materials like maybe your glass or maybe a tin or maybe aluminium or maybe wood, etc. So it is not that it will make a difference. By necessity, people will have to use it. Today you don't even think of using a glass bottle for milk, for the simple reason that it's a burden on the environment, because the carbon imprint is so huge that you rather use a plastic bag or a plastic pouch, use your milk, get your milk, and leave the plastic bag for recycling.
So talking about recycling, we have heard of various innovative ideas like building roads with plastics, or be it converting dead plastics into reusable fuel. So this is definitely benefiting our society. But don't you think the government should be keener in promoting these ideas by extending a helping hand?
Yes, I think so. The thing is that perhaps the government has been too much bogged down with so many other issues and problems that this has not percolated to the policymakers as effectively as required. But nevertheless, the recent notification, recent guidance by Ministry of Environment and Forest, by the Central Road Research Institute, etc., they have advocated, they have almost made it mandatory for your municipalities and for state governments to look into this, that as far as possible, material that cannot be recycled can go in for applications such as what you mentioned just now for road making. As a matter of fact, we were pioneers in this. India was a pioneer in this. Today, so many countries of Asia have come to India, looked at what we are doing, and tried to make the same use of plastic waste as we are doing. So at the same time, also for oil, in the sense you can, because after all, what plastics is hydrocarbon, made from hydrocarbons. So what you are doing is bringing it back to the earlier stage. So once again, that's one more application. But there are many other applications for reuse of plastics or recycling.
So, thank you so much for your valuable insights, Mr. Merchant. With camera person Aniket Jain, this is Pratiksha Karkera from Polymer Update, the fastest growing petrochemical market intelligence company in the world. Polymer Update is a world-class renowned provider of business-critical industry news and real-time price alerts. If you have enjoyed watching this video interview with Mr. Merchant and have found it to be useful for your business, please subscribe to our channel by pressing the button below. Many thanks for watching.